Everybody, welcome to Soul Code. So we're always talking before we come on camera, and we're laughing and just being crazy us. And so this is this week's session of the Soul Code, and I am here with my co-host Lorilet Monegro, and we just got to step back a little bit and just take a few days for ourselves, and that was really nice. I had a lot of fun, and we did work, but in a peaceful way, where we didn't have any constraints or pressure on us. And while we're away, like whenever we talk about how we should be grateful for today and the things that are all around us and God in our lives and the people in our lives and how that all impacts us on a day-to-day. I really value my peace, so I'm not that person that can sit in a negative space without telling those people, okay, I'm out. I'm out. I can't sit here. You're rubbing my positivity off. So, but I am grateful for every moment. And you have such gratitude in your life, and I just so appreciate that. But while we were away, we also received some bad news, some people passing, both on TV and personal lives. So we want to talk about these different moments and how they affect us, and how a lot of people are, as Lorelette would say, are checked out of reality because they don't want to be here. So we're gonna talk about that.
I can be a little energetic when I say that, but it's because, I am constantly inviting people to check in because you know what? I invite myself to check in. I call myself in the third person. I go, Lorelette, I do. When I'm realizing, wait, you're not paying attention. I call myself, I counsel myself, I coach myself, and I bring myself back to reality. I'm like, wait, rethink that. What did you just do? What did you just say? What was that about? I question myself. And I think that, we have to check into reality. And sometimes reality is painful around us. It's not always joy. And even then, to try to find a way to turn whatever it is into moments of gratitude and being grateful for what does exist, what is right now. But like you said, it takes us separating. And honestly, I'm working on being so present that I want to be thankful for everything. For everything. I'm like, oh, and I want to pause intentionally, pause, because I don't know where we're rushing to, but everybody that I've seen is going to a place that, it's unknown. So I don't know that I want to be so rushed to like not live this moment, even if the moment is giving someone a hug. Like, I don't have to rush to do that. I don't have to rush to thank someone for something simple that I may be taking for granted, and I don't want to be that person. I want to like not do that. I don't want to, I want life not to escape me. So I need to bring myself each time. No, be here right now. This is the point of being mindful, which we talked a lot about, by the way.
Yes, we did. And I started talking to my group a little bit about being intentional and what that looks for and what that looks like and how that drives your outcomes. So while we were away, I finished a kid's book and published it. And if I was home, I probably wouldn't have did that. But you kept saying, just do it, just do
Yeah,
it.
I was like, just do it, just do
Just
it.
do it.
I really wanted to just see you have that win. And for me, my win was there too, but in a different way, because it was more about processes. As you saw, I would be like, okay, this is the problem. What's the solution? This is the problem. What's the solution? Because I'm very process oriented. I can't change who I am. And so this is why I was like, okay, she got to do this because she's right there and she got it. And it's just like, it's almost like when a baby's coming, you want to just come on, give me the baby push. I'm waiting.
I love it. So I was, but I felt really good about getting that done. And you're working on one too that you did a while ago, and you're putting that together, and that's going to be amazing because I love it.
Yeah, it's almost done.
Yeah, I know. And we might be the next best authors in the world. Who knows? Who knows?
If we're not, we're putting it out there, and I think that that is what makes us the best already. You
Yeah,
know, like
I
it,
think.
and I don't say this lightly. I mean it because guess what? Like for me, I'm so into like that iteration. You know, kind of like I'm going to use a term that maybe may seem weird, but many children on the spectrum do that. They repeat on that constant loop, you know, but I don't see it as a negative thing. I see it as a relearning and a relearning, and that's why they can be so perfectionistic even about their artwork or drawing or writing or whatever they
That's
find
why
that,
they're
you know.
savants in so many areas, and
Oh, yes.
I think they're savants in a lot of areas,
Oh, yes.
and I think it's that repetition, and
Absolutely.
I think that we spend so much time, like you said, racing, that we really don't honor ourselves in that perfection state where we do take the time to give time to our craft anymore, or to really perfect what we love, that everybody's always on to something new instead of mastering. Like I've been in my profession a long time. You just don't hear of people staying in the same profession anymore, or sticking with something and loving it as long as I've been doing it, and it lights me up to this day. But there's so much going on around the world today. So I employ women from Kenya, Bangladesh, all these different places. And there's a lot going on in Bangladesh right now. All over the world. I turned on the news this morning, and two women, I think. I only caught part of it, were just thrown in the subway. And I took my little ghetto self, and I said, I need to get away from this, right? So we always go back to our roots. You can't take the Bronx out of me. So when I was a kid and things were uncomfortable in the house, or people were arguing or yelling, I used to go outside and sit on the fire escape, or I'd go up to the roof and just watch, people watch, or do all these things. So today I said, well, I got a roof. I don't know. Go to that roof. So, and that's what I did. And I just sat there in silence and just enjoyed what was around me and just cleared my head. I just let my head go blank, which was difficult because it keeps trying to circle the drain.
Yes, it is. It's, you know, it's a constant chatter, constant chatter. We all have it, whether people admit to it or not is a totally different issue. But, you know, it's not something we can turn off because just part of how we make meaning of the world and understanding through the thoughts and the words and the ideas that we generate. And that's what our brain is designed to do all of the time. And I think that once we kind of show it, wait, there's nothing right now for you to process. I want you to just stay calm and use your five senses as a form of delight. It's a totally different instruction wherein we can be experiencing whatever it is, but all of a sudden you will notice the birds, you will notice the sounds, you will notice the colors, you will notice everything around you in a different, elevated, appreciative state, which brings your breathing into a different place because your wavelength, your brain is accessing a different part of you, a different state. And that's something that you are now creating with intention, volitionally creating, as opposed to letting whatever subconsciously run scripts keep going and going and going on autopilot. So those moments matter, whether it is at a fire escape, because we talked about a little bit how you can create these spaces. You can create these moments even during your lunch break. You can create moments that are very unique no matter where you are. All you need is to say, please give me a minute, which I just go like this, give me 1 minute. And I shut off everything. Sometimes in my own office, I would just go ahead and turn off the lights. And I'm like, okay, it doesn't matter. It's my lunchtime right now. I'm going to take 5 minutes first. I don't want to eat anything. I don't want anything. I want to shut down every stimuli that's coming in right now. I close my eyes and I just regroup and I get myself exactly where I need to get to. And I say to myself the affirmations that work for me, the different words that I need to, again, it's almost like a form of self-coaching, if you will,
Yeah.
because I don't have someone telling me it, but I'm directing my mind, and my mind is going to do what I tell it to do.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I told you that people will, when I'm at work, will walk by my office and they kind of peek in to see who's on, like, what's Andra up to? And if I look at them like, no, then they just keep on walking. But
Like run away.
they know my look, and then they'll come back like an hour later and peek in again, and I'll wave them in. But if I don't wave them in, they know, leave me alone. And I've had to create those boundaries for myself even at work. So, because people will drain your energy. They'll keep taking and taking and taking. So even when I get to work, like I take a train to work every day and I listen to my affirmations there. As soon as I get there's different distractions,
Energies, yes.
and they're all mixed. It's like the weirdest thing. My breathing is even different when I walk into that building. I notice that. Mary Morrissey used to say, "Notice what you're noticing." So
Of course.
when I walk in that building, I notice that I feel congested all of a sudden. I don't know what it is, but
It also could be a stress response, right? Because it's by association. If you start like noticing that, it's important to actually start noticing, what are the antecedents that have led to this kind of, framing and almost paired association that by default your genetic makeup coils into whatever that response is and responds accordingly, your cells shift in the messaging. And so that has to be some anchored experience, whether that was an experience related to some traumatic events, right, that may have happened there, or just plain and simply a sense of dis-ease in the surrounding either people, right? It's a matter
Well, I
of
think it, but I
breaking
don't.
down what it is. Yeah.
I know it's the air quality is very different in there. We used to have an old furnace in the building, and they removed it and put in a newer system that never works, never functions. So it's cold over here, hot over here. So as soon as I walk, I have chronic sinusitis. So as soon as I walk in, my nose says, "Oh, you're not going to be happy today." So I go in my office, and I have this vapor thing in there, and I get into my happy place, and people will come by to say hello, and I'll go and I'll turn on my tapes and I'll start those affirmations. Because I think that as people, we need to reaffirm throughout the day. So it's one thing to start your day, but I need those affirmations on the train to get me
Absolutely.
into that mood, and to bypass all the stuff that's going on around me.
Yeah.
But then when I get to a new place, it's like I'm reaffirming, okay, this is going to be a great day. I am happy,
Yes.
healthy, wealthy, and wise, whatever that is,
Yeah. Yeah.
and I reaffirm that, and that starts my day off in a good way. And
It matters tremendously,
yeah,
the way
but
we
a
talk
lot
to
of stuff.
ourselves.
And a lot of times I will leave them on in the background, even if I'm working, because you don't have to intentionally be listening to them for them to absorb. I know that sounds
Absolutely.
a little off base, but it absolutely works. That if they're in the background, like if you just start listening to affirmations today, then you should probably listen to them all week to get your mind retrained that this is the route we're going. But when you've been listening to them for a really long time, just hearing them in the background can impact your belief system. Even books,
It's like anything, yeah. It makes
I've
sense, like
played
subliminal
books.
messages.
Yeah, I've played books. I told you the other day, you looked at me like, what? I used to sleep with books.
Yeah, you told me that.
I'd put the headphones on and I'd go to sleep with that book. And I definitely remembered a lot of that book.
I wouldn't be able to just do that.
I did, but I used to listen to the nursing tapes at night before I went to sleep. I would listen to them when I went walking in the morning. I would listen to them no matter what I was doing. And it became my routine to listen to them. And they kind of lulled me to sleep. But I think that your brain waves are in a different place when you're actually relaxed in sleep. And I think that you're
Absolutely.
still absorbing and processing
Absolutely.
information. So
Yes.
I feel like I learned better that way.
And that would make sense. It's kind of like when you're tapping to your subconscious level and you are taking a software and you are updating, which we talked a little bit about the concept of just updating our mental software and how we do that is exactly through these processes of learning, right? And I think that now with artificial intelligence, that we're kind of really exploring the collective force, right? That intelligence in itself generates. We're getting more sophisticated if we learn how to use language in a supportive way, right? Because it matters. Just kind of like when we talked a little bit about, hey, people think that if they just take a chat GPT that it will do everything, but it's not quite that way. You would have to spend time programming the outputs, how you want to shape it up, all of that. And that sometimes takes months, if not years, if you are not necessarily an expert in how to do all these kinds of things until you get to that. But we're lucky to be in a time where we could actually advance our knowledge base, share and co-create. If we're going to put out anything of value, we can always also revalidate it with the collective understanding that's out in the world. And it's a whole process.
But it's good for research. So a lot of people have some mixed feelings about Chat GPT. So a lot of people think that it's regenerating the same stuff, and I don't believe that it is. So and you know my friend. So I think that you have to have knowledge to impart that knowledge to Chat GPT. So
In
even
itself, it
people,
can't do anything.
no, correct. So, you see a lot of people today going online and creating programs and doing all this stuff with Chat GPT, but if they don't have the knowledge for that area or that niche, they do have to do that research to give him something to create. So he's not going to just create it based on, hey, I need this. So you do have to give him specific prompts. You do know how to talk to him, because even if he's a machine, no tiki, no laundry. So if you don't put in, you're not going to get that out. So you have to really, you do have to know it. So a lot of people think it's easier, but for those people that really don't know what they're doing and they're using it in a bad way, that does show. Because you can, he's only going to give you what you put in. So,
Absolutely, the
check.
quality of what's putting in, yeah.
Yeah. And they're not as updated as quickly. Like someone in, if someone was using it for, say, medicine, right? Medical knowledge is always changing. So, if Chat GPT's last update was 2019 and you are using it, then you're not putting the most current stuff out there. So you do have to know, you do have to be knowledgeable
And
on
you
what
have to,
you're creating.
No, but also the research. I'm one of the things that I like to do throughout the week normally is I like to always pull out a few articles because it's for me, it's easy to just pick up an article and read it. I could read it during my lunch break. I can read it at home 20, 30 minutes, read something, consume something, and I'm like, oh, I have a few good points here. You know, this is great. And you do that 4 or 5 times in a week, and you've read 4 or 5 articles, you know, you don't have to make it this big production. People think that you could just sit down one whole day and binge article read. That's not quite the best way to do it. You know, when you're trying to really uncover a specific topic and, you know, you want to inform your own understanding, which is part of also the other conversations we were having about, you know, how do you just first extract what you know and then build out from there, expand, ask for suggestions. How could I improve this? Or, you know, things of that nature. I think abusing artificial intelligence in a way that is exploitative and just doesn't really serve anybody. Like, it would be quite disingenuous for somebody to use this tool and just make up that they know something that they have no insight into, right? And some, you, I'm sure there'll be people like that that be
That's half the
using,
people online today.
you know, using this tool and then act like,
Half the people online
you
today.
know, like a smarty pants. I'm gonna use the word pants because that sounds better than something else that starts with an A. But you know, you're trying to be like this smarty pants over there, but you've never dealt with it. You're not even versed in it, you know, you're not. And so I think that when it comes to having insightful, engaging interactions with the public, I think all of that will show if you've never really consumed the material, read the material, practiced, or done anything. I think it'll just show you won't be able to know the industry that you don't know.
But being an expert, you know, nobody starts an expert, right? So you do have to go and acquire that knowledge. I've been doing the same thing for 40 years. I'm still learning. I
Exactly.
still make it my business to stay on top of what's new, you know. I teach people nutrition. Nutrition doesn't really change that much. The concepts are still the same. But the application can change based on the clientele you're dealing with. Like how you would support that client. So I'm always looking for new innovative ways to help people. So, but you can use those type of tools to do your research. You know, can it, in a simple way, can you tell me what's most current in nutrition? You can ask him that. What's the newest thing? And then if something in that interests you or it's something that you want to explore, you could say, where do I find this research? And you know, who's this by? You know, can you give me a link for that? So it does cut down your time, but
And also the organizing piece. One thing I do appreciate is the organizational aspect of it. It's like taking information and really streamlining it so that you are not, again, being inefficient. The efficiency piece of it is something I marvel at, and I can see how the future, right? If I imagine what 10 years ahead will be like, I think, you know, just because I think about how it was when we used to get the CDs with AOL and America
I
Online, and you know, you used to get
remember.
the CDs shipped to you, and it was like insert this AOL 3.0 and blah blah blah. I remember the world at that time, and even how, you know, you would access the email, you got mail, and it was like all this big thing. And you know, I think back, and now I'm seeing we're right in front of this new innovative technology and just how the speed of things, right, is happening so lightning fast. And I think, wow, in 10 more years, you know, everything that we saw in the Jetsons will become true.
Yeah, I remember that show. I loved that show.
Yes, I know, me too. I loved it.
Like Lost in Space.
You know, it's so incredible, but we're actually like living all these things that were once in a lifetime prior, only imaginings. And we've basically brought it to life. Like we've manifested it, if you will. We kind of pursued these ideas, and somehow we've brought something that was in the future through a cartoon, maybe. And we're seeing it right in front of us. And it's kind of like, again, the same concept of why it's important to use positive language, positive affirmations. Not because you're delusional and you're making up stuff. The world may be crumbling around you and you're like, oh, everything is perfect and great. No, but your ability to remain in a focused state are probably higher when you've trained your mind to be disciplined. And it's a big process. When we come back to the idea of loss, sense of loss, losing, with loss comes that deep, deep, profound awakening and appreciation. And I think we need to do more of appreciative interactions with others. We don't do enough of that. People find it awkward when you are just genuinely loving and kind. And I it's the weirdest response. It's the weirdest
Because it's
response.
something they're not used to, so it's difficult for them to understand because they don't see it. It's a different time in society. There's a lot of division in the world, and people just aren't used to that. But the only way that we can be a part of that change is to be the people that we expect to see, right? So be the
Yes.
person you want to see in the world. So we can show that gratitude. We can bring that in and find that peace. Because, like you said the other day, it's really hard to be angry when you're out in nature and everything around you is beautiful, right? It's really hard. Oh, this is
Is.
so good. Oh, look at all these blooming damn flowers, right?
Yes.
And it's very hard to be
It's
that
very hard.
old person when you're out in that, and it's beautiful.
I have never heard of someone who is like, angry at being in front of water, in front of a beautiful river or a lake or the beach, in front of beautiful nature and trees and the gorgeous sunlight and just all that we have been given, and having our ability to just experience it. When you become attuned to all of that, all of a sudden you can really find that you love a lot of things in life. You love, I'm going to speak for myself. I find that I love everything that I have. I find that I love every inch of my being I'm grateful for. Even when I feel that things could improve, when I go work on whatever I got to improve to the best of my ability. To the best of my ability. I'm not perfect because, it's like what I was telling you that sometimes people who are like the way we tend to be. We can be pretty extremist, right? And so sometimes if we get upset or angry, doesn't mean that I always know the right answer or know how to process it. I have my moments. I am not a machine. And I would be like, no, I may have a bad moment or bad reaction. Just the same way, I am all for justice. But I don't like when people think that justice is equal to doing whatever you want. That's not justice. For whatever reason, not sometimes people think that when I speak this way, it means that everything is perfect. Yay! And I'm like in cloud number 539 out there that no one can find. No, I'm very grounded in reality, but a reality that is full of optimism for what the world has for us,
Well, I
right?
mean, there's a lot of negativity around us, and we could choose to focus on that negativity and bring it into our internal self where it's not causing good in our body. Or
At
we could
all.
focus on a brighter day, a positive outcome, and have hope and faith that things are going to get better. I've been through a lot of trauma in my life. But I always maintain that hope, and a healthy dose of sarcasm.
You gotta laugh
I'll
sometimes.
fix your ass.
But you know, sometimes people are like, what are you doing? You're being so clever, whatever, or you're being this witty, or you're whatever. And you're like, you better learn to laugh at yourself because you know what? You have no idea what kind of crap I may have been through in my own life. So take it as a nice compliment, as a nice moment, because you have no idea what depth and maybe what I feel is deep to me may be nothing to the person next to me, right? Because that's the beauty of our own inner learnings, right? They don't necessarily, is not one size fits all. What is valuable in someone's eyes may totally be worthless in someone else's perspective. And so we have to kind of start laughing a little more, you know, and not being so rough, you know. We can be really tough. We can be really, really hard people. We can be brutal sometimes, actually, you know,
I
and
agree. We're gonna
more
end this.
love.
We're gonna end this on this note because we want to end on a positive note. So we want to just put that thought in your mind. Just place that little area there that reminds you to be more hopeful, more grateful, more tactful in your encounters with people that you endure during the day. Or you encounter during the day because you never know what kind of day somebody else is having. You never know what day will be your last day. So live today like it is your last and try to impart as much positivity and kindness as you can on every individual you meet. Something as simple as good morning can change someone's day dramatically. So that's enough from us. We kind of went from A to B to C to D to G. When we get together, we could talk about a million topics. So we want to thank you for coming in and spending time with us this week. We love coming in and imparting our views, and we're so grateful that you're here, and we hope you have an amazing day. Take care.
Ciao.